Operational report. Submarine detected. Detections, recon over the Japanese army. Crash, 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 crash. Oh, holy crow. Oh. Kill credit, kill credit, kill credit. Transports moving to division. Transports moving supplies. Refit all those PT boats. Upgrades. Planes returning to the pool. Upgrades. Here come the two reinforcements, Brunei and Tarakan. First order of business, take the ships under repair. Make sure we turn off no upgrades for them so that they don't go continuous upgrade. Shouldn't be a problem, but never hurts to be safe. Now we check for damaged ships. We have, holy cow, look at all those damaged submarines. But let's take a look at the damaged ones. Make sure there aren't any more collisions. Yeah, we're worried more about the collisions than anything else. So still McCracken and Latimer. They're both at Pearl Harbor. Let's get them both repaired. Look at that damage. Wow! Okay. Well, it doesn't matter whether it's critical or normal, so let's just leave them at normal. It doesn't matter. Same 11 days, so we may as well leave them at normal. We're going to check submarines now. Jack. Holy cow! That's a cripple. She may very well sink before we get home. The Muskalunga also returning. But not a cripple. Lastly, Raton. Oh, we are a Raton already returning. No other ships appear to be damaged. Torpedo check. Pompon, Lapon, and Jack were the ones that fired. They still have torpedoes. It doesn't matter that Jack's got torpedoes. She's flooding like a son of a gun. I'll be lucky to get her home. Ah, why? I found it. Okay. Why am I going all the way back to Manila? Let's put into one of these lovely ports that we have up front. We only need a small port. But also, got to remember, don't steal the fuel out of these guys. Muskalunga is also right near a port. Why don't you just come in here, relax, fix yourselves? Actually, Muskalunga, Muskalunga didn't even use any torpedoes. So we don't have to worry about torpedo resupply. And Raton, baby, that's what these little ports are made to accommodate you. Excellent. There's one more ship I should be looking at, and that's the Merrimack Seam. Because it slowed down to an 11, we're going to go to Task Force 219. And we can see that most of the ships here are speed 12, but this son of a gun is going to speed 11. Doesn't say what happened to it. It wasn't a collision, so it just broke down, idiot. Anyway, I'm going to form it up. We're going to set it on alone. If he has to sink, he sinks. Because I'm not going to hold back the entire group of 30 ships for one damaged idiot. Let's also take a quick look at the victory screen. Notice that we have shot down or destroyed 136 enemy aircraft. Not bad, right? But we lost 34. So even though it's a 4-to-1 kill ratio, I consider that a loss. We lost yesterday. I think that the more proper kill ratio is around 6 and 7. I've had as high as 20. But 6 and 7, or else it's the AI has won. Singapore. We keep getting hit here. The damn Firefly is going to take another 3 days to get repaired. Crap. Okay, I'm gonna start using the bow fighters on combat air patrol mode. We're gonna put them at about 10,000. We have enough pilots. Yes, that should be fine. I'm gonna put the Spitfires up high because they seem to do okay up at the 20,000. Let's see if that'll help. The Mustangs are gonna stay down at the 15. They could go high, but I might switch them around later. Miri, we are loading. It's still, look at how much loaded. 340, 300. I don't know if I'm going to be able to pick up the entire division the way this is going. Here are the troops. Amphibious. Oh, pardon me. No. It's these guys are loading. Loading. And it's good that we're at 25, 24%. So 24%. We can load right up to 100% because this is a transport group. Not an amphibious group. So there's hope that we get all four, but it's loading so slowly. At least it didn't sail away off to Miri, off to Brunei right away. So that's good. So we're holding it here. They're unloading until they go. They're going to hold here until they finish loading. The aircraft have arrived. Yahoo! Beautiful. And guess what? We can transfer out of here without repairing, without an airfield. Remember that my concern here was there's no airfield, and the reinforcement were arriving on a dead, I don't know, a non-existent airport. Let's get these guys out of here first. How far can we go? Oh, they got pretty darn good range, but we don't want to go that far. Let's go to what's the bestest here? Either Clark or Man okay, Clark stacked all the way to hell. At least there's more support over at Manila. Let's go to Manila. We'll leave that for now. We'll train. However, we still have two damaged aircraft here and no aviation support. Maybe we fix it tomorrow, maybe we don't. But let's not leave things to chance. If we cancel this and decide to load, we can pick up the air group. There will be enough. We're not going to load. Okay. Reload. Nothing else is coming, so we may as well pick up this baby. We're okay with that. The other reinforcement came at Tarakan. Tarakan, we can tell by the reinforcement it's a 40 level. That's why I don't like to use the 40% level. When reinforcements arrive, they usually show up as a 30 or a 40%, and that's a pretty good indicator that it's a reinforcement. Oh my gosh, a Dutch Air Force. This is a waste. I don't know if they might have some replacement planes, but there aren't any pilots. Once these guys die, that's it. Done. Okay, so we're gonna go. Actually, we'll go. I'm gonna change this back to 40%. We'll transfer over to. Gee, let's go 90. We can't even get anybody to fill up the squadron. Okay, let's go over to. I'm going to Clark Field because everybody's at Clark Field. And I'm just going to jump over to Clark Field right now just so that we make sure all the level bombers are still hitting the same target as before. So those are the two. There are more, I believe there are more reinforcements coming at Tarakan. Of course, you can't just press it and find out. We have to do the searching. All right, there are going to be more reinforcements arriving at Tarakan. Brunei, we're just waiting for the retrieval. Here's Miri. I've got these motor launches in, and I should have sent them back earlier. So I'm gonna form them up now. There's about nine of them. I'll form, and I'm sending them back to. Well, jeez. I guess it's fine. Let's go to Singapore. It's usually quite. It's pretty much pointless. Oh gosh, can't even go back to Singapore without some damage. That's fine. We're gonna form two groups like this. We'll form two small groups to hopefully evade any detection by the enemy. We've still got two down here. They're being repaired, and once they repair, I'll send them on their way tomorrow. Still loading at Balikpapan. I think we'll be okay getting out of there. At Davao, we're playing the game of, oh yes, we're trying to catch up where the parents are, grouping them together, disbanding, so chasing fragments again. We do have a night fighter squadron, the Fireflies, and we brought them down here to upsize because there's only 12. Okay, that means we need to clear off one of the carriers. I guess I could go try to send it over to Guam, but it's too much hassle. I'm just going to clear off one of the British carriers and use it to resize. We cleared off the Implacable and flew them on here. It's a maximum of 81. I think 81 plus 15% is 93. So let's see if we can't get it up to a 93 here. Excellent. At Legazpi, the LSTs have managed to evacuate. Land, but I forgot to turn it. Ah, crud. I forgot to turn them to unload, so I lost a little bit of time there unloading. Now we unload. And the transport, the Ravanas, already here. Then we go back to Pelelu and pick up some more. On the second thought, I think I'm going to pick up Iloilo and Bebe first. Now this transport group, we have to send all the way back to San Francisco. I don't know why it wants to go up there first. Let's use a waypoint. We want to keep it up here and across. At Manila, the little support tender will dock, replenish, and put the little yard patrol in for repairs. This is the tender from Davao. Now that we have cleared the base, we're gonna form up all those extra tenders we had before, send them back to either Pearl or San Francisco. And with the losses we took at Apari, I'm bringing a squadron, one Corsair squadron, up to Apari to reinforce. And I noticed that it only had about 50 fighters above up on Clark Field. That's maybe why the enemy was able to attack. Okay, we've got some of these night fighters here. These are the British. They've got 100 pilots in here already. I was using these. Well, these are carrier trained. But I think I want to get up 100, use up all 100 of them. So I'm probably going to upgrade with the Seafire, since we don't use them anyway. I think I'm going to do the same with the Marines. They're looking for 100 fighters here. They're all on training. Yeah, they're all trying to gain additional experience. So I'm going to upgrade these to... Oh, we have 100 here? Okay. Oh, gonna cost me 50 points, is it? You turd. Alright, do it. That way we can free up the 24, and the 24 plus the 81 here, that'll be 100 for somebody else. Also, looking at losses, I have to plan well ahead. I'm going to stand down three of the Corsair squadrons in case there's a need to cycle and give these guys a break. Several infantry units have arrived at San Fernando. This is the end of the rail line, so we have to get them off the rail and start marching them towards the target. Manually. It still looks like there's a little movement pip here. I've got there's 600 in tanks already. Now the question is, do I attack? It's not good terrain, but these are tanks against enemy infantry that's already been hit a couple of that's already been bombed badly. So I'm going to try it. I'm going to try it. I know that if he gets across the river, he can cause, well, not so much damage. We're going to survive. We're going to survive it, but it can cause a lot of consternation. Atapari, we're going to order these ships. Okay, we're going to meet up with the group at Baton Island. Do not, and refuel. Bobolink, same. I think we can get out to Baton Island and disband, meeting up with these guys when they arrive. Wow, the enemy hasn't attacked Baton Island for a couple of turns now. Does that mean he won't come? If I drop a base force on here, am I just wasting the effort? I think I can spare one base force, so we're going to drop it. We're going to order everyone to stop here, let them unload one day, and then everybody head south. I'm going to put a squadron of Hellcats up here and a squadron of Corsairs to help bolster the defense. I'm going to stand down, order the Lightnings to stand down. Why? And I'm going to transfer them back to Manila to recover a little bit. Because these are the only big groups of 75 that I can get, the army squadrons. The rest are on the ships right now, and they won't arrive for a few more, well, many more, another week or so. But I'm going to need the 75 if I'm going to relieve, if I need it to relieve Nago or Naha. Nago took a pretty heavy beating here. We had 75, lots of damaged aircraft. Now they got their own. They got a piece of the enemy, and they got a lot of them. But doesn't mean that the enemy isn't going to can't beat us down with human wave attacks. Since we're only allowed to take reinforcements once a week, I'm going to divide this group, and I'm going to flood it with reinforcements now. Just load it right up, each group. We're already overstocked on the base, so it doesn't. A little bit more. I think it calculates in increments of 100 of 50. So if I'm overstocked, I could overstock to 199, and probably I think it incurs the same penalty. Ah, so the little gunboat tender did manage to draw an attack. So we're gonna dock him out here again. Hey, it's not much fun playing bait, is it? At Naha, I think the fatigue went down 1 point, so I think it's helping by flying at only 80% at night. We're going to use the same principle for the P-47s. We only allow one reinforcements once a week, so let's get them all loaded up now. Get all you can, boys. The convoys pass south of Iwo Jima or near Iwo Jima in relative calm. Holy cow, Hahajima! Actually, we actually went up a little bit in supply. That's good. But let's take a look at the supply ships here. We'll take support, and we can see that they didn't come in with a full load already, but they came in pretty close to. Let's say they had about 41,000. I think they had about 40,000, 40, 41,000 when they came in, and they've already look how much they've eaten up. Holy cow! Those battleships just the guns just devour the ammunition. We might have two more bombardments before we run out of ammunition and have to retreat to Iwo Jima or send them further to get ammunition. The AK continues to d unload, but it's so slow. Even an AK takes this long on a level one port. Okay, so we're gonna form up. Oops. Let's go battleship. We're going to do a right click. I'm going to leave the ones that the thousands and the high, but I think everything else, yeah, even the 600s, we're going to bombard with everyone else. Make sure we go with cruise speed, and we're not going to let the bomb escorts bombard. Their small guns aren't that effective, so it's just a waste of ammunition. The These two battleships, they've used up their operations points, so we'll have to wait for the next round. The landing craft are going to try to bring in the rest of the base force. Unfortunately, they picked up the radar. Good. I didn't think they could pick up the radar, but they did. It's already on the ships. Nice to see. We're rotating the fighter squadron combat air patrol again. He's got a little bit of fatigue. Just keep rotating him, bring him down to zero. If worse comes to worse, I guess I could always pull one of these babies over to Okinawa. They also have 75. I've rerouted the convoys that are retiring for the United States. I'm going to put it right over Iwo Jima. There's enough engineering capability here that we just don't need. I'm going to detail some of the ships to try and pick. If the convoys are not going the northern route, this exercise, bombardment exercise, is just practice guns. Putting the battleships at risk for almost no reason, but if I can wipe out the enemy and capture the base, I'll capture it, but I'm not going to waste a lot of time trying to build it it's just not worthwhile trying to build it and drop supplies onto it. I don't need it as a patrol base around here. I just need the enemy off of it. At Guam, we continue to load the AOs. Hopefully by maybe two turns, we'll be finished. The British squadron that resized to 100, we have a couple of aircraft ready now. Let's see. Let's try to use drop tanks. How far can we go? Oh, we can go all the way up to Legazpi. I'm going to put them at Legazpi. Oh, wow. That's just wow. Wow. I've been putting most of the British ones here, but we've just really overloaded that base. They're all overloaded. Manila's the only... Okay, sure. Let's go Manila. At least there's still some room there. We're doing a lot of training here. See, look at all that. Look at all that. All that lovely green, huh? We're not getting any experience, unfortunately, but the skills are going up. All right, let's see what happens if we disband, send some pilots to the pool. Sure. The transports leave Woolly Eye. Unfortunately, we didn't manage to pick the whole thing up. We still have 44 truck motorized units remaining. Well, I never thought I'd do this, but I'm going to actually pull a unit all the way back to Liyue, bring in these base force engineer naval support back to the island. Maybe we can unload, get them to load a little bit more quickly. That's just incredibly how stupid that situation is. I thought I might need it to help get these guys off here, but these guys aren't even the problem. The LST should be able to unload those, should be able to retrieve them fine. That mess over in Lihue and Hilo is just an ungodly traffic jam. The AOs have finally finished their loading and are heading towards Hajima. The transports have arrived at Dutch Harbor. We'll form up. Oops, no, just transport. Let's see. If I form one. Hold on. Why did I get a whole choice? I don't understand. How did I get a whole bunch of choices when there's only three units here? Let's try that again, right? Load troops. Okay. Well, that's better. Let's see if I can't create that bug again. All right. Let's form transport. Oh, we didn't. Okay. These are being loaded. Maybe they're being loaded. And this one doesn't have enough. So after all this, looks like we're coming back to pick up more. Yeah, I'm sure that's exactly how they planned it in World War II. They just guessed every single time. Okay. So no matter what you do, you're going to be running around. We'll have to come back and pick up maybe two fragments here. Midway, the patrol bombers, they're recovering. They're just resting a little bit. Okay, let them shed the fatigue before we fly forward. Still unloading. 5 days and we're still unloading. 6 days and we're still unloading. Hilo, we have a couple of transports have actually finished loading, but the rest have not. So I'm going to break out the ones that have finished loading, send them off as best we can, while the other ones just keep loading. The same log jam is happening at Lihue. We finally got a few tankers. They're almost finished. They're close enough to finish. I just get rid of them. Just get them out of here. Maybe that'll give some room on the docks to the other ones, other ships. One thing to note, aircraft have been detected at Truk now. Could that be a threat as we traverse? I don't know. We've been traveling south between Guam and Ulithi. That's the route here and then up. So if he's got if the AI has a few squadrons of bombers around here, that could be an irritant, more than an irritant. Pearl Harbor struggles to load tankers. We have a couple more. We have three finished, so I put them up, send them off, but the others are just piddling around. Look, they're halfway here. And these guys, look at how much, not even close. The two damaged ships returned. They dropped off their charges. So now we're going to, may as well put them into strategic mode. We don't need the amphibious mode anymore. And when they're ready, they'll pick them up and take them over. In the middle of the ocean, three streams of convoys, one from Vancouver, one from San Francisco, and one from Los Angeles, they seem to pretty much merge all around here. So the carriers are each grabbing one task force, the fastest ones, and meeting up with them, and then following them. Los Angeles, we have some more tankers have filled up. I'm separating between the 14 and the 16s. I don't know if they're going to sail at the same speed, but yeah, it's a 3-knot difference and it's a big ocean. So I think by the time they get to the other end, they will be quite separated. Okay, so we now have room for a few more tankers at Los Angeles. We continue the loading. The tankers at Mare Island have finished. Just in time, and they're leaving now. The tankers at San Francisco are also finished at the exact same time. Off they go. Two transports have arrived from Los Angeles, I think it was Port Hueneme, and they're going to pick up an artillery unit and the remainder of this United States Navy base force. It's nice to see that San Francisco actually has quite a few aviation support once you gather everything together, and it's more than we need, but we can't get it off the mainland, so it's just subs attack a landing barge group. Spikefish cannot get a solution. Bugatta hit by an E-boat escort. Night raid on Naha. The Hellcats get one. Ah, crap. Night raid on Iwo. Yeah, looks like we'll have to fly some night combat air patrol here. Another night raid on Iwo. Bombardment. Whoa! That's good killing. That's pretty good killing. Springer intercepts a transport convoy, sinks the transport. Hardhead also intercepts a transport convoy, sinks it with two torpedoes, but takes 26 hits We might have it might be sunk. Hardhead sinks. I don't think it was worth an exchange. We probably lost an 8-point sub, I think, for probably a 4 or 6-point transport. We'll check it. Air raid, Singapore. 26 strikers. One shot. Ah, crap. That's pretty terrible. Air raid, haha, Jiba. Betty's going after the task force. Must be after the bombardment group, I think. Two shot down. Air raid. Three shot down. Air raid, Baton Island. Oh, he's going after the transports as they try to land. Eight destroyed. Oh, pardon me. Wow. Wow. That hurts. Air raid, the base at Nago. 136 interceptors, 10 shot down. Air raid, Nago. 6 shot down. Nago hit again. Another Betty destroyed. Baton Island Task Force. The Judies. Oh, these guys are fast. But we've got 14 of them. Task Force at Hahajima. The Betty's attack. No losses? I think that's probably because of no radar. Same as what's happening over at Baton Island. Without the radar, there's no early warning. Baton Island attacked again. This time it's the base being attacked. Minor losses to the Japanese. Oh, 14 misspoke. Half the raid is destroyed. That's because half the carriers are sitting right on top of the hex. Air raid, Naha. Air raid, I think this is the task. Yes, task force. 9 Peggies. 2 are destroyed. Naha attacked again. Half the Helens are shot down. Singapore, air raid. Oh my goodness, those bowfighters are not very good. 7 shot down, but we still lost a bowfighter. Oh, you can see that these are the bombers flying back to San Francisco from Hawaii on their own. See? I don't need to click on it. Pito fires, and he's hit 6 times in return. Oh, Springer. Ah, Springer got luck. I wonder if she was damaged already. But she did manage to sink one before she was sunk. Deliberate attack near Apari. 9-1 odds. Oh, but we lost 2 vehicles destroyed. Okay. Heavy.